Should you use free podcast hosting for your podcast? I'm going to make the case today for using free podcast hosting. I know, it's a little bit weird. I run a paid-for podcast hosting company, Captivate.fm, 7 days free over at Captivate.fm. But when and what just merits the use of free podcast hosting? Let's get into that in just 1 second. This is the Podcast Accelerator. I'm your host, Mark Asquith, that British podcast guy and CEO and founder here at Rebel Base Media, where we make Captivate.fm the world's only growth-oriented podcast host, where we make the managed WordPress platform for podcasters called Podcast Websites, and of course, Podcast Success Academy, Productivity, and Rebel Base Studios, the Sheffield podcasting studio. Now, there's so much just kind of fluff that goes on in podcasting, in particular podcast hosting. People get really, 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 really naughty when it comes to kind of appraising podcast hosting. I'm talking people that you wouldn't expect to get so rude, get really rude online when they believe that their paid-for hosting company is getting slighted in favor of a free option. And these are people that I respect, and I just think it's a little bit silly. It's a little bit ridiculous. So today, I'm going to do something a little bit bizarre. I'm going to make the case for free podcast hosting. Why? You should maybe consider, if you are just starting out, an option that is free, but it comes with a heck of a lot of baggage and a heck of a lot of caveats, all right? So we're going to dig into that in just 1 moment. But before I do that, just a heads up, that of course, AWeber is still giving you 90 days free to try their email marketing platform. Why would you want to do that? Well, email marketing is still the best way to engage with people. It's still the most revered way of contacting and interacting with audience and listeners in particular as a podcaster. So what I want you to consider here is that, do you have a relationship with your audience? Have you got people on an email list that you own as opposed to just a Facebook group that you do not own? Okay, if the answer to that is no, please go and check out AWeber for 90 days totally free at markasquith.com/AWeber. Right, free hosting such as Anchor, for example, gets a bad, bad rap at times. And more often than not, that venom is directed from podcast purists and from a very defensive angle. Now, I understand that. I really, really do understand that, and I hear that. Free podcast hosting, though, in my opinion, has its place. But it's a very, very specific place. Now, I'm in the podcast groups all the time. Sometimes I'm commenting, sometimes I'm bloody lurking. And what I find is that so many people that I respect and have got so much time for turn into complete berks when it comes to discussing free podcast hosting. They will get venomous. I can think of at least 2 or 3 people that have published things that I would not expect, using language that they should be embarrassed about. And it's because it's got their backup. Okay, it's got their backup, and there's no reason for this, all right? I'm always a big believer in assessing things on merit and looking where things fit in, and generally never speaking rudely to people. Now, free hosting, honestly, let's be completely clear with this. Let's be 100% clear. If something is free, you are paying in other ways. If you are not paying financially, you are giving something else. That is the deal. You get a free ebook, you give your data. You use free podcast hosting, you give your content. You give license somewhere, somehow, to your content. It might not be a complete license, but it will be something like a reuse license. So there's plenty in there to unpack, okay? But free podcast hosting does have its place. However, I don't believe that you should use free podcast hosting to grow your show, but this is the thing that we have to understand, and this is why Captivate.fm has been designed to be very, very simple. The churn rate, the attrition rate, the people that leave Captivate is tiny. The amount of support that we get in respect of the numbers that we've got is tiny because we've designed it to be frictionless and obvious. And that is the key. Free podcast hosting is obviously a case of firing up your phone, recording into the microphone, and then publishing it. All right, that is frictionless. Now, there are other ways to do that, But for someone that just wants to try podcasting, that wants to start talking about Crisis on Infinite Earths from DC and the CW, that wants to just do a short form show, or wants to just sit around with friends and just spin up a podcast on a Friday night, free podcast hosting via an app on your phone is often fine. It's often fine. You're not going to build a show from it. You're going to find yourself restricted. You're not going to get great analytics. You're not going to get your own brand, your own product. And you are going to give up and compromise certain things to that company. But to get started, I would rather you used a free podcast host and started, and then 10 episodes in, realize that you need to switch, than thinking to yourself, well, do you know what? I don't even know if I'm going to stick to podcasting. So I'm not going to pay X amount per month if I'm not going to do it. I would rather you tried it, dip your toe in the water, and then realize, actually, I'm compromising too much with this free hosting. I'm going to move to something that's paid, something like Captivate.fm, which is it's ridiculously low price. It's great value. You know, I would rather that you got started than never got started. And if that means that you are using something free, don't worry about it. Go on, all right? But just don't be naive to the fact that you are going to compromise. You're not going to get the right analytics that you need. You're not going to get the quality of interface. You're not going to get the quality of scalability. You're not going to get the support that you need. You're not going to get any of that stuff. But if you can press a button on your phone and record, fine. But it will only take you so far. So like I said, I would rather you did that than not ever get started at all and then look to move into something like Captivate.fm, okay? So don't feel bad about it, all right? Don't go in the Facebook groups and just, if someone does berate you for using free hosting and make you feel stupid, because people do, like people I see so much in like podcast movement community, should I use this free podcast host? And then someone will jump online and go, well, if you're a fool, or if you believe, or if you're naive, and if you blah, blah, blah. Screw that, all right? Don't let anyone make you feel bad. Don't let anyone make you feel stupid. It's those guys that honestly, they're just a little bit annoyed for no reason, all right? Must be having a bad day. So I would rather you get started and then move to something like Captivate, all right? Just try it. Give it a whirl. Podcasting's open. It's free. You might not stick to it. You might bloody hate it. Who knows, all right? But give it a whirl. And I'm going to talk on the next session about when and what to look for in a new host. When should you move? The case against free podcast hosting is my next episode. So kind of if you're diving into this episode, go and jump into the next one as well, because it'll kind of top and tail it. It's the sequel. It's the Dark Knight. Right. Thank you so much for joining me. It's always a pleasure. Go and check out Captivate.fm if you want to look into some proper and some scalable podcast hosting where you can host unlimited shows for just one monthly cost. Tell your friends about the show if you think they would benefit from it. And until the next time, I honor you and I respect you and I love you very deeply for joining me every single time. So until the next time, never forget, the more you expect from yourself, the more you will excel.